Hey guys, so in this particular video we are going to make a very interesting and very important topic, which is data analysis. We are going to analyze some data properly, and it's a very famous data set on Kaggle.com which is based on the real estate prices. So the aim of this data set, the aim of this project is to build a model which can predict the house, predict the price of a house. Okay, and then we are going to compare the real house price and the the price that has been predicted by the model. So this whole playlist is going to give you a very good idea of how to analyze the data, how to perform the feature engineering, and how to build your model. And also feature selection will also be there in this particular lecture. So this is a four-part lecture, in which in the first video we are going to analyze the data that we have got from the Kaggle.com, and the second video we are going to perform the feature engineering. In the third video we are going to perform the feature selection, and the fourth video we are going to build our model. So let's start with the data analysis from this particular video. So basically we'll be dealing with the data set. So I'm using Google Colab here. What you can do, you can use the Jupyter notebook, or you can use the VS Code, but I'm using the Google Colab. And what you can do is, if you are using Google Colab, what you can do, you can go to your Gmail account, okay, and then in the this is my Gmail account, AI Society, and then what you can do, you can upload the training data set in your particular folder, okay, in a particular folder, and then you can simply click on this icon, and when you'll be clicking on this icon, you can the drive that is being connected with this Google account will be connected automatically. Or if it is not connected automatically, what you can do, you can click on your Gmail account that you want your drive to be connected. So simply click on this one, and then the drive will be mounted in a particular notebook. Okay, so now let's import some of the libraries here. Let's say we are importing the three libraries from NumPy, and import NumPy as np. Simple libraries, we have import pandas as pd, import matplotlib as plt, simple as that. And then what we can do, we have to call this matplotlib inline to perform the why the matplotlib inline is being used, to so that we can show our graphs, we can show our images in the notebook itself. That is why this matplotlib inline is used. Okay, so all set. Now it's all set. All the libraries that we wanted is imported. Now we have to read the data set. What we can do, we can say data is equal to, we can simply say data is equal to pd.read.csv. And what we can do, we can put our link here. Not link, it is basically the path of the data set. So what you can do, you can click on the, your drive will look like this. Okay, and then click on the drive, click on the my drive, okay, and then just a second, go on the folder that you want, and then click on here, copy path, and simply put the path here. The data set will be readed here. Okay, the data set will be readed automatically here. Now what we can do, we have to see the whole data set. This is the data set that we are going to have. Okay, this is the data set. And what is the shape of it? Let's check the shape. Data print data dot shape. Data dot shape. And it's 1460 by 81. Okay. So let's move forward now. We are going to analyze the data set. So what does data analysis mean? It means we have to analyze data in a particular format, not form. So what does data analysis actually mean? So what we can do, let's see. So we are going to analyze the data, right? So basically when we are analyzing our data, we need to analyze for the missing values. we have to check for the missing values. We also have to check for the numerical, since we are dealing with the numerical data set. So what we can do, we have numerical variables. We have to see which are the numerical variables. The since we are dealing with the numerical data set, our only interest is in numerical variables, no other variable is going to help in building our model or prediction our prices. Okay, and we also have to see the distribution of numerical variables. We also have to see the distribution of the numerical variables. Also, we have to check for the outliers. We also have to check for the outliers. We also have to check for the categorical variables. We also have to check for the categorical variables, and also we have to check for the cardinality. Cardinality. We also have to check for the cardinality. I'll explain what do I mean by cardinality of variables. Okay, but I'll tell you. And also we have to see the relationship between the variable and the target. So what is the target in this? What is the target? Let's see. We have to see this particular line. Okay. So now there was an internet issue here. So probably the part is cut. Okay. So now we have these variables. We have these data, and if we see the sale price, this is the sale price, and this is the target variable here. So we have to predict the sale price, right? So this is the target we have, and we'll be working on this particular variable. So this is the difference between target and the variable. So we have to see all the relationship between the sale price variable and all the other variables. So we'll be checking the relationship between all the variables and the sale price, which is the target. Let's see the info, the whole thing about data set. It will tell you everything about data set, what is there, how many null objects are there, everything will be covered. So yeah, so we have these much data sets, and 81, since it is starting from zero, we have 81 variables and 1460 rows. So 81 columns and 1460 rows. Okay, so basically, as you can see here, in LA we have only 91 non-null. That means rest of the values are null here. And here also, as you can see, 1452, that means it is having 8 null values. It is also having 8 null values. So there are many null values here. Okay, here we have 7 non-null. That means all the other values is null here. So basically, the whole data set is having some null values. So let's see which are the variables that are having null values. That means missing values. Null values means missing values. So what we can do, we can make a list of missing values. Okay, we can make a list of missing values. Okay, so what we can do, we can have var variable with NA. Yeah, variable with NA. Okay, and what we can do, we can use our list comprehension. Var for var in. Okay, and we have what is the variable name? Data, right? Yeah, data. Data dot columns. Data dot columns. Okay, if data of var dot is null. Okay, we are using list comprehension here. That means it is checking for every variable in the columns. It is checking for every variable of the columns if the any of the variable is having null which is greater than 1. Okay, which is greater than 1. So that means this will create a list of all the variable that is having the missing values. Okay, and then it will look like this. Let's see. Okay, we are having an error here. Let's see what's the error. Okay, we have to put dot is sum to dot sum. Okay, so we are having all the variables. Let's see with NA. Okay, so these are the variables that are having the missing values. Okay, and now let's what we can do, we can create what we can do is we can create the variable and the percentage of how many missing values are there. So for that, what we can do, we are having for where in where's will iterate over the list of all the variables that are having the missing values, and then we can say simply print where. Okay, and what we can do is we can calculate the null value of it. We can calculate the null value of it, then mean value. Okay, so we are going to calculate the percentage, right? So this is we are calculating the mean of it. Okay, and yeah, and that's it. No, actually what we can do is the mean value will give us the whole big number. So what we can do, we can put a round here. We can put a round here, and that round will be by 3. Okay, and then we are going to have the see the missing values. Let's see how it looks like. Okay, we are having an error here. Okay, it's not null, it's null. Yeah, so we are having the this particular variable, this particular column is having 0.177% missing values, and Ali is also having 0.938% missing values. Okay, so there are missing values in our data set, lot more missing values in a data set. Okay, so basically our data set contains some variables that are having the missing values. Okay, and now what we can do is we can check the relationship between the missing values, the variables with the missing values and the sale price. We are going to check the relationship between the variables that are having the missing values and also the sales price. So what are the factors, does those variables that are having the missing values affects the sale price or not, that will be seen in this particular cell. So for that, what we can do is we can create a function of it, and we can call it as analyze NA value. Okay, and it is going to accept two things. For one is data frame, okay, and other one is the variable. And then, okay, now what we can do is we can have df is equal to df.copy. So okay, the data frame will be accepted here. What is the data frame? The data variable that we have created, the variable that has contained all the data, this one. So you'll see that value will be coming here. Now what we can do is we can create a variable that will indicate one if there is a missing value present, and it will indicate zero if there is no missing value present, if there is not a missing value there. Okay, so you'll understand what I'm saying. So what we can do is we can grab the variable, and there is a very famous function, famous method of NumPy, which is where, and what it does, it will return the elements chosen from x or y depending on the condition. So we have to give the condition first, and then we have to give the what is the option it has. So basically the condition is df of where, okay, df of where is null. Okay, and the options are 1 and 0. If the condition will be true, then it will return 1. If the condition is false, it will return 0. It's as simple as that. Okay, and then it will calculate the mean sale price, and now what it will do, it will calculate the mean sale price wherever the missing value is present, wherever the missing value is present, it will calculate the mean sale price of it. So how it will do it? It will do it by giving group by. There is a very famous method, everyone knows that, group by, and we are having variable, and then sale price is there. Okay, we are going to grab the sale price, we'll be calculating the median of it, and then plot a bar. Okay, so what it has done, it is calling the group by function method on the var variable, and then it is grabbing the sale price. Remember the sale price column here. Where is that? Okay, sale price column. This is the sale price column. It is grabbing the sale price column, calculating the median of it, and then plotting a bar of it. Okay, so now let's see how it looks like. Okay, what we can do is we can give a title also here. Title of var and also plt.show. Not df, we have to put the plt here. Okay, and now this is the same thing that we want. The same thing we want is for all the variable, not only the sale price. We want this for all the variable. So now we are going to call this function for it. For where in where's with na, no, where's with na. Okay, and then we'll call our function analyze na value, and then we are going to perform, give the data set and the variable. Simple. So now all the missing values, there are a lot of missing values present. There are a lot of variables that are having the missing values. Now all the missing values will be analyzed using this analyze any value, and it will give zero. It will provide, it will create a plot graph of it. It will create a, sorry, bar plot, and it will provide one if there's a missing value, and it will provide zero if there's not a missing value, and it will calculate the mean sale price of it. So let's see what it looks like. I hope there's not an error right now. So let's analyze what it is showing. As you can see, this is the lot front age variable. Okay, and one is having the missing values. Remember what one indicates. One indicates if the observation was missing, then it will indicate as one, and if it is not, it will indicate as zero. And then it will calculate the mean sale price where the information is missing or present. So this is the mean sale price of wherever the there are missing values. This is the mean sale price between $175,000 to $150,000, and this is the mean sale price where the information is not missing. And it is done for each and every graph out there, each and every variable out there, variable that are having the missing values. Okay, so you can see it. Okay, if you're having any problem, just comment down. So basically the graph is perfectly shown now. So again explaining, let me write it here for you. So what this line is doing, it is making a variable that indicates one if the observation was missing, and zero otherwise. Okay, and now what this is doing, it is calculating the mean sale price where the information is missing or present. Simple as that. And once we have done with it, so basically now you understand this. If you're not able to understand, read this comment again, you will be able to understand it. Okay, let's move forward now. And okay, so we have got information, a lot of information here. So it is affecting the variable somehow. The missing values are affecting the missing values, the sale price for now. Anyways, so since we are able to see that the missing values is affecting the sale price quite a lot, then we have to deal with missing values somehow.